Subscribe the channel Prostech and press the bell icon to get latest technology videos once we release. More importantly, the subscription to the channel is completely free. Friends, Samsung Galaxy A70 comes with Android 9.0 Pie, uses One UI interface and powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon 675 processor with 2.2 GHz octa-core and GPU Adreno 612. Whereas Samsung Galaxy S9, it runs Android 8.0 Oreo powered by 2.8 GHz octa-core processor, Exynos 9810 Octa or Qualcomm Snapdragon 845 chipset and with Mali G71MP18 or Adreno 630 GPU depends on the region where it is launched. If you see the display of this device, then you can find 6.7 inches screen size with Super AMOLED display that comes with a resolution of 2400 by 1080 pixels with 393 ppi pixels density. Whereas Samsung Galaxy S9 is 5.8 inches device with Super AMOLED display having resolution 2960 by 1440 pixels with 570 ppi pixels density. Friends, moreover, Galaxy S9 comes with front and back Corning Gorilla Glass 5 with aluminum frame, Samsung Pay and 3D home button. This phone is IP68 certified, dust or waterproof over 1.5 meters and with 30 minutes. Talking about the internal memory, then Galaxy A70 is available in 128GB with 6 or 8GB RAM and also supports microSD up to 512GB with a dedicated slot. Friends, as far as concerned about the colors for this device, it is produced in coral, blue, black and white colors. Moving on to Galaxy S9, here you can choose internal memory between 64GB or 256GB of storage with 4GB RAM. Internal memory can be expandable via external microSD up to 400GB that uses SIM2 slot. Friends, you can enjoy this phone in various colors like midnight black, coral blue, titanium gray and lilac purple. If we talk about the dimension of Samsung Galaxy A70, it measures 164.3 by 76.7 by 7.9 mm of height, width, thickness and 183 grams of weight with dual nano SIM option. Whereas dimension of Galaxy S9, it measures 148 by 69 by 8.5 mm thick smartphone weighing 163 grams with front and back Corning Gorilla Glass 5 screen protection and with hybrid dual nano SIM standby options. About the camera, then Samsung Galaxy A70 comes with triple 32+8+5 megapixels primary camera setup with 1.7, 2.2 and 2.2 apertures with ultra wide angle and depth sensor. It shoot out full HD videos at 30 frames per second, HD videos at 30 or 240 frames per second and also equipped with 32 megapixels secondary front camera with 2.0 aperture with HDR and 1080p recording at 30 frames per second. Coming to primary camera of Galaxy S9, it comes with 12 megapixels with 1.5 aperture, phase detection, autofocus, object image stabilization with LED flash. You can also find geotagging, simultaneous 4K video and 9 megapixels image recording, touch focus, face detection, auto HDR with panorama mode. Friends, you can find different video shooting modes in this device that can shoot videos of 2160p at 60 frames per second, 1080p at 240 frames per second, 720p at 960 frames per second with HDR and dual video recording. Moreover, as far as concerned about secondary camera, then this smartphone comes with 8 megapixels front camera with 1.7 aperture, autofocus, 1440 pixels at 30 frames per second, dual video call with auto HDR. Friends, in Samsung Galaxy A70, you can find fingerprint scanner under display of the phone. This device also comes with different sensors like accelerometer, gyro sensor, proximity and compass. On connectivity side, you can find Wi-Fi, dual band, Wi-Fi direct, hotspot, Bluetooth, GPS, NFC, FM radio, Type-C reversible connector and comes with fast battery charging. This phone is also powered by 4500 mAh non-removable battery as well. Whereas Samsung Galaxy S9 comes with different sensors like fingerprint sensor mounted on the rear side of the phone, repositioned just below primary camera, also having iris scanner, accelerometer, barometer, gyro proximity and heat rate. This phone is also having Wi-Fi dual band, Wi-Fi direct, hotspot, Bluetooth, GPS, NFC, Bixby, Samsung DeX, fast battery charging with quick charge 2.0, type C reversible connector and powered by 3000 mAh non-removable battery as well. So that was the quick comparison of both smartphones. You can also check further details in the description below. What do you think about these smartphones? Do let us know in the comments section below. I hope you liked this video and don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching.